I'm Kyle Cardwell, and this is a birdhouse I designed based on the 1960s architecture movement called Archigram. To help my birdhouse design make sense, I will first give a brief explanation of Archigram and the philosophies of it that I added to my birdhouse. These are the original founders of Archigram. In 1961, this group of six architects got together to discuss their views on the architecture of their time. They were Warren Chalk, Peter Cook, Dennis Crompton, David Green, Ron Heron, and Michael Webb. A quote from one of the founders describes their feelings when they started. "The first Archigram was an outburst against the crap going up in London, against the attitude of a continuing European tradition of well-mannered but gutless architecture that had absorbed the label modern, but had betrayed most of the philosophies of the earliest modern." What were they reacting against? This is London in 1960. It's difficult to see any novelty or variation in architecture, from standard usage of bricks to endless glass windows, and that's what they wanted to change. Some have said that Archigram was to architecture what the Beatles were to music. Between 1961 and 1970, the founders produced 9 editions of the Archigram magazine and used pop art as their medium to express their ideas. One goal of Archigram was to get people excited about the future by pushing the limits of technology as much as possible. For instance, a suit that could transform into your bedroom, or even a chair that supports you by jets of air. Archigram also had big ideas for city life. Plug-in City was a system of interconnected buildings that were devoted to continual circulation. Individual apartments were made mobile and modular so that people could easily move and plug in their home. Expanding on the idea of mobility, Walking City was an attempt to make massive, mobile collective dwellings that could freely roam the world, to bring people into contact with the elements, and to transcend national boundaries. More than anything, the Archigram designers wanted to change people's perception of architecture and make every part of it an interactive experience that could only be made possible by the active involvement of its inhabitants. Thinking about all the aspects of Archigram and how I was going to design my birdhouse, I first thought of the typical functions of a birdhouse so I could keep those in mind while trying to rebel against conventional birdhouse designs. Most birdhouses are set up outside of a house to invite the birds to live near you, but they're still kept separate. So why not bring the birdhouse inside to integrate the experience more into your life? Bringing in inspiration from Plug-in City, this birdhouse can be installed easily by being plugged into your home, and it's not more difficult than replacing a window or simply putting a hole in the wall. Having a birdhouse that would be visible from both inside and outside of a home led to a form that is highly function-driven. What is outside is recognizable to a bird, but what is visible from inside a home allows for active participation and interaction with the birds. Drawing from Archigram's Walking City led to a backboard idea to allow any number of the birdhouses to be set up wherever the homeowner feels that it fits best, by rearranging these circular coverings. As with Plug-in City, individual birdhouses can be different sizes, but are still able to be arranged in a number of ways because of their modular design. This is just one example of how they can be arranged. Birdhouses can be added or subtracted to create the feeling of a birdhouse community. If more birdhouses are wanted, a bigger backboard would be necessary, but for just one single birdhouse, a smaller one could be used. Part of the forward thinking of Archigram was to push the limits of technology. Today, modern technology innovations of transparent LEDs are being developed for computer, television, or even cell phone screens. These LEDs could be applied to the birdhouse walls, and when turned on, would not only create an interesting decoration, but also help the birds feel that they're in a safe and secure place to live and raise a family. This is the view from inside one of the birdhouses with the LEDs turned on. From this perspective, the question arises, who, really, is observing who? Finally, this Archigram-inspired birdhouse could serve as an easy excuse for bird watchers to enjoy their hobby from the comfort of their very own homes. Thank you for watching.